welcome to Dixon's elastomer replacement video for the JRZL-115 frac pump. Before we get started, there's a couple things we want to cover. Number one, you're going to want to disconnect the pump from all power for safety reasons. Number two, you may need to flush the pump out with some warm water. There's only a few basic tools needed. There's no special tools. And in addition to that, there's no torque ratings on any of the bolts. You need an O-ring pick, half-inch wrench, a wooden dowel, and then some lubricant for your O-rings. For the purpose of showing the ease of elastomer seal repair on the unit, we have chosen to take a brand new pump out of service. The brand new pumps have thread covers on them. In the field, you would not need to disconnect your hoses that are attached here. You'd be able to do the elastomer repair in the field. Additionally, when you take the front cover plate off, you're going to want to make sure that you clean this plate using something that's non-abrasive. You don't want to grind anything into this plate. You don't want to use any harsh chemicals because it's a machine surface. The seals in this pump are EPDM elastomers standard. Take your half-inch wrench, and you're going to take off your four acorn nuts. First seal is your cover plate seal. Next, you're going to take your rotor bolt tool off the side that comes standard with the pump. Tool is notched out to take your rotor bolts out. Take your wooden dowel, insert it between the rotors, take your tool, loosen the bolt. All you need the dowel for is just to simply loosen the bolt. It's important to use this tool and not a flat screwdriver. A flat screwdriver will leave a burr, and that burr can rub against that flat plate that we just disassembled, and that can cause your pump damage. Your next set of O-rings, your rotor bolt O-rings, simply pull those off, lubricate the new ones, put them in place. These bolts have lock washers, so you don't need to torque them. You just flatten the lock washer when you reassemble. You're going to pull these rotors straight out. These rotors are paired, so it doesn't matter what order you lay them down in. You can put them back in any order, and it'll work just fine because they're paired. So you pull them straight out. Your next seal is your rotor seal. This is a tungsten carbide seal. It's slotted and you can see pins inside. Take your O-ring pick, just gently lift up. Pull your tungsten carbide out. Set that aside and you'll see that there's an O-ring right inside here. Simply pick that out, of course lubricate the new one. Put it in place. Next, there's a tungsten carbide seal that is behind the shafts here. They only fit in one way. They're slotted. There's pins on the inside. Simply take those out off the shafts. Tungsten carbide seals. Again, they only fit in one way. You can rotate them around. They recess right around the pump shaft. In place. Put your tungsten carbide seal. Once you've replaced this seal and lubricated it, just line this seal up with the pin. Push it in place. Doing this repair yourself is quick and easy. It'll save you weeks. You don't have to take the pump out of service and send it somewhere to have it done. Again, these are paired rotors. Doesn't matter what order you put them in. One tooth is smaller than the others. Simply find the tooth on the pump that's more shallow, line it up, push it in place. That simple. Find the tooth that's more shallow. Again, line it up. And just put it right in place. Very easy. Put your rotor bolts back on. You can snug them just a little bit before needing to use your wooden dowel. Again, once these lock washers bottom out, you'll know it's tight. Stick your dowel in place. Just that simple. Bottomed out, nice and flush. Cover plate. Put your cover plate back in place. Just that simple.